Interfaces are a way to describe the shape of an object in TypeScript, providing you as a developer with a way to ensure that all objects follow a specific structure. This helps to reduce the amount of errors that you see in your code, and it makes it easier to debug it in the long run. By the end of this video, you'll understand interfaces, how they work, and how to use them in your next TypeScript project. So here we have an empty TypeScript file, and let's create an interface. So we're going to call this interface. So to use an interface, you need to use the keyword interface. Once you have that, you need to give it a name. Just like when you do const and then a variable name, interface also needs some sort of name that you can then reference. So I'm going to call this I with a capital I and then user and then create an object. So now you get to set all of the property names and the type that they're expecting. And you can also do things like void for a function, and you can also denote just variables in general. So I expect there's going to be a name here. So we'll expect that to be string. We'll give this user an age, and that will be a number. And we'll say is active, and that could be a Boolean. Credit card will be a string. And then finally, we'll do hello. This will be a function. So we're going to expect a string, and then that will return void. So now we have an interface. How do we use this interface? So if we were going to just create a user, let's say user, we can use the colon and then reference our iUser in the interface. So we can say iUser. Now we have all of this, thank you, TypeScript, and it tells us exactly what we expect. So we can put an age in here, and as you saw there, it tells you what it should be, number. So we can just do 52. We can say name, and we'll set that to Steve. And then we can have a credit card number, which should be a string. And we'll set that to 424242. Shout out to Stripe. We'll set isActive to false. And then we can do hello, which is void. So what's expecting here is some sort of function that doesn't return anything. So it would be like console.log. So we're going to pass in the string. So that would be text, for example, and will be string void. And then we can just open our parentheses and type whatever we want in here. So we'll just do console log text and hit save. So now we're using everything in here. We've got no issues. If we go to command J, there's no problems. Let's delete out credit card, for example. So if we delete this out, hit save, you can now see we have a red squiggly line under the user. And if we look at what it says in here, it says property credit card is missing in type. And then it tells us what we're using. This is what everything that's here, and it is a required type. So how do we denote something is not required? Maybe it's optional. So you can do that by adding a question mark to the beginning section here of the declaration. This question mark means in cases where it is not included, that is fine, but in some cases it will be there and it should be a string. So now if we hit save, this user is fine. Everything's great about this user. So that's one example of using an interface. But you can also use interfaces to denote what should go into a function.
Sorry to interrupt the video, but if you are enjoying it, make sure to hit that like button. And if you're new here, subscribe as you'll get more content around the Jamstack.
And we can do it a little bit better here. So under here, let's do another interface. I'm going to call this iUserProps. Now this will all make sense in a minute. So when we're doing something like const, let's say user function equals, and you do this takes no arguments right now, and that's it, right? And in some cases, you need to know what you're passing in to this property. Let's say we have a name, age, city, like this, right? Then we could do a return here and say return, and we'll just do a string here and say name is age and lives in city. So if I just go ahead and comment all this out up here, we create a user, so we say const user, user function. So this function that we're using. And then we pass in everything that we need. So we need an age here, so let's say it's a 42. We need a name, call myself Steve again. And then we need the city, and we'll just say Raleigh. So we got this function, now we can do console log function. And if I do this and go to our terminal, then if I run node.index.ts, you'll see Steve's 42 and lives in Raleigh, which is all fine. That's probably what we expect this to be like. But right now, all of these are set to any, and this could be a JavaScript function that you've used in the past, and those numbers just come from somewhere in your application. So what happens if I change this to true? Now it says, Steve is true and lives in Raleigh, which is definitely not what we want. So we want to make sure that the properties that come into our function actually are the right ones. So we can do that by closing this out. And we'll go ahead and uncomment this interface down here, the one that we were using. And then we can make this function take in our interface here, our props. First, we'll do our name. And just like before, it'll be a string. Age will be a number. And city will also be a string. So now we've got those, we can add this to our function. After the deconstruction here, so after these curly braces, you can add the iUser props. And now you automatically get the same kind of idea here. This age got a red squiggly line. If we hit Command J, we look, it says type Boolean is not assignable to type number. So we can set this to 52 and everything is happy. We can also do other things. So let's say we have membership and we all know our membership is only going to be two properties. It's either going to be basic or super. So we can actually denote that membership is going to either be basic, and then using a pipe, we can say basic or super. Those are the only two options. Now, if we add this to our user props here in our user function, and we say membership, and then we open the string, you'll see that the only values that are available are the ones that we want. So let's make it super. And then obviously we can add it here, say membership, and then that would be available in here, and membership is membership. And this also works if we expect something to either be a type or null. So for example, if we credit card again, maybe we expect that to either be string or null. So it still has to be included. We have to include it in our properties, but it could be one or the other. So we could say credit card, null. And this person doesn't have a credit card, but we could create user two here. Everything's the same, but he does have credit card. Both of those are valid, still one of those could work. So I hope you enjoyed this basic introduction to interfaces. If you did enjoy this video, make sure to click the subscribe button on screen, and I've left a playlist on the right of some Next.js content.